Dear friends, English literature, romantic poetry, William Wordsworth, selected poems, She Dwelt Among the Untrodden Ways. Short questions with answers. Short questions 1 to 9. Question 1. Why is Lucy compared to a violet covered with a mossy stone? Answer. Wordsworth metaphorically compares Lucy to a violet covered with a mossy stone. Violet is a wild, uncultivated flower. It is a symbol of innocence and modesty. Normally, a violet blooms within a bed of leaves and it is hard to recognize with the leaves. So it remains half-life from the view. The very fact that a violet is placed by mossy stone means that people will fail to notice the beauty of the violet as it will be overshadowed by the sliminess of the mossy stone. To the poet, however, Lucy is special and he is the only one who can see how beautiful she really is. This comparison highlights Lucy's innocence, hiddenness, simplicity, modesty, and her isolation as well. Thus, by comparing Lucy to a violet, the poet has given her the characteristics of the flower. She is not compared to a rose because a rose is too well known, is highly cultivated, is too well liked, and symbolizes love. Another interesting possibility may be that the poet loves Lucy very much and she gets married to another man. Then the phrase "a violet beside a mossy stone" will make more sense, as the poet is still loves Lucy and hence compares her to the violet, but looks down upon her husband and compares him to a mossy stone. Question 2. How does Wordsworth describe the beauty of Lucy? Answer. Lucy is a beautiful girl. Wordsworth compares her to a violet covered with a mossy stone. Violet is a symbol of innocence and modesty. Normally, a violet blooms within a bed of leaves and it is hard to recognize with the leaves, so it remains half hidden from the view. The very fact that a violet is placed by a mossy stone means that people will fail to notice the beauty of the violet as it will be overshadowed by the sliminess of the mossy stone. To the poet, however, Lucy is special and he is the only one who can see how beautiful she really is. The poet again emphasizes her beauty by comparing her with a star. The poet says that she is as fair as a star, as she is compared to only one star shining in the sky. It suggests her brightness and her unique beauty. As she is compared to a single star, it reveals her loneliness. Some critics think that the single star may be Venus, who comes out all alone after sunset. Venus is also the goddess of love and is and in contrast to the violet, open for all the world to see. Question 3. What is the main theme of the poem that she dwelt among the untrodden ways? Answer. Wordsworth is a poet of nature. In She Dwelt Among the Untrodden Ways, he expresses his deep love for nature. The poem deals with Lucy, who lives in solitude near the source of the river Dove. She is an innocent and beautiful girl, but she has none to praise and few to love her. She has remained unknown and lonely in spite of her beauty and innocence. She has died young. Her death is cause of deep personal grief to Wordsworth. Her significance to the poet is made very clear when he utters, "And oh, the difference to me." Though he is greatly affected by her death, people are indifferent to her death. He shows that for the great majority of people, her death means nothing. These simple people are marginalized. He's the only one who feels the immensity of the loss of her loss. Her death makes no difference to the world, but it makes inexpressible difference to him. For him, she represents rare beauty and great value, but for the others, she is worthless. In the poem, we see Lucy as a gift, product of nature. Lucy here is a symbol of nature that is neglected. No one appreciated the beauty of this girl who lives in natural places. As she represents the unspoiled nature, her death can represent the loss of nature. Wordsworth laments the loss of nature, while simple people remain unmoved by the loss of nature. This makes him different from other people. Question 4. How does the poem She Dwelt stand as a lament on behalf of all people who go through life unnoticed and unappreciated? Answer. She Dwelt among the Untrodden deals with Lucy, who lives in solitude near the source of the river Dove. She is an innocent and beautiful girl, but she has none to praise and few to love her. She has remained unknown and lovely and lonely in spite of her beauty and innocence. She has died young. Though she has died untimely, people are indifferent to her death. Wordsworth shows that for the great majority of people, her death means nothing. These simple people are marginalized. He's the only one who feels the immensity of her loss. Her death makes no difference to the world, but it makes inexpressible difference to him. For him, she represents rare beauty and great value, but for the others, she is worthless. Thus, the theme of this poem is that the noble and virtuous sometimes receive little or no attention during their journey through life. They are blazing stars who soar through the heavens unnoticed or seldom seen, then burn out and die. Thus the poem can stand as a lament on behalf of all people who go through life unnoticed and unappreciated. Question 5. Write down the summary of the poem She Dwelt Among the Untrodden Ways. Answer. She Dwelt Among the Untrodden Ways is a three-stanza poem written by the English romantic poet William Wordsworth in 1798. In the first stanza, we are told that Lucy dwelt among the Untrodden Ways beside the springs of Dove. She is part and parcel of nature. No one treats these ways. So her existence has been unknown for people. She lives a lonely life because she is unmarried. No one appreciates her beauty and innocence because she remains unknown. She lives in isolated places which are not familiar to people to walk in. The poet shows that people do not care about the simple and innocent villagers who live in the midst of natural surroundings. In the second stanza, the poet describes the beauty of this countryside girl. She is beautiful and delicate like the flower which grows on mountains among rocks. The poet compares her with a violet covered with mossy stone. She again compares her with a star. The poet shows that her beauty is unique and distinguished, but it is not noticed because she is confined to isolated and solitary places. In the third stanza, the poet emphasizes the idea that the girl has remained unknown and lonely in spite of her beauty. She has died untimely, but people are indifferent to her death. Her death is a cause of deep personal grief to Wordsworth. However, her death has no effect on other people. For him, she represents rare beauty and great value. But for the others, she is worthless. Question 6. Discuss the poet's use of imagery in She Dwelt Among the Untrodden Ways. Answer. In the poem, the poet depicts an image of the natural surroundings among which Lucy lives. He provides the reader with a visual image when he says that Lucy lives beside the springs of Dove. The image appeals to the reader's sense of sight. We again find an image of Lucy when she is compared to a violet covered with a mossy stone. Normally, a violet blooms within a bed of leaves and it is hard to recognize with the leaves. So it remains half hidden from the view. The very fact that violet is placed by a mossy stone means that people will fail to notice the beauty of the violet as it will be overshadowed by the sliminess of the mossy stone. This flower grows in a context which does not make her beauty emerge. This shows that Lucy's beauty is concealed in this place. In the poem, we find another image of Lucy's beauty when the poet says she is as fair as a star. The poet likens Lucy to a star which sparkles alone in the sky. This image reflects the charm and the uniqueness of Lucy's beauty. She is distinguished from the other people. This image also reveals her loneliness and isolation. She has no company. No one appreciates her beauty. Her existence has remained unnoticed. Question 7. Describe the characteristics of the poem She Dwelt Among the Untrodden. Answer. The poem is written in the form of a lyric. It is a lyric with elegiac undertone. It has the characteristics of an elegy, as in the poem, the poet laments a person's death. It has also the characteristics of a ballad, as the poem tells a bit of a story. It has the following characteristics. Number one, the poem uses simple diction. Number two, the poem is simple only in appearance. Number three, its language is so lucid and ordinary. Number four, it has used the typical ballad meter of iambic stressed unstressed, in which the first and third lines typically have four stresses and the second and fourth have three stresses. Number five, its words mostly consist of one syllable. Question 8. Write a short note on Lucy poem. Answer. The Lucy poems are a series of five poems composed by the English romantic poet William Wordsworth, 1770 to 1850, between 1798 to 1801. The poems were written during a short period while the poet lived in Germany, but all but one were first published during 1800 in the second edition of Lyrical Ballads. In the series, Wordsworth sought to write unaffected English verse infused with abstract ideas of beauty, nature, love, longing, and death. These poems include strange fits of passion, have I known, she dwelt among the untrodden ways, I have traveled among unknown men, 3 years she grew in sun and shower, a slumber did my spirit seal. The Lucy poems are written from the point of view of a lover who has long viewed the object of his affection from afar and who is now affected by her death. Lucy is Wordsworth's inspiration, and she is presented as an ideal. There are numerous interpretations about the identity of Lucy. She may have been Wordsworth's beloved sister Dorothy, but Lucy may also suggest Peggy Hutchinson, who Wordsworth was in love with and who died in 1796. Lucy may be an imaginary, beautiful and ideal English maiden. Some critics think that Lucy is an expression of Wordsworth's nature and spirit. Question 9. Write a short note on Lucy. Answer. Lucy is an idealized English girl who died young. She is Wordsworth's inspiration for writing Lucy poems, and she is presented as an ideal. There are numerous interpretations about the identity of Lucy. She may have been Wordsworth's beloved sister Dorothy, but Lucy may also represent Peggy Hutchinson, who Wordsworth was in love with and who died in 1796. Lucy may be an imaginary, beautiful and ideal English maiden. Some critics think that Lucy is an expression of Wordsworth's natural spirit. In the Lucy poems, Wordsworth shows his unrequited love for her. Her death weighs heavily on him throughout the series, imbuing it with a melancholic elegiac tone. She is seen as a mountain girl who lives in a solitude near the source of the river Dove. It conveys the dignified, unaffected naturalness of Lucy. The isolated and untouched area where Lucy lived proves her innocence and beauty. He compares her to a violet, which is a symbol of innocence and modesty. He again compares her with a star to emphasize her beauty. The poet laments that in spite of having beauty, innocence, and purity, she is neglected by people. There is none to praise her beauty except the poet. Through her character, the poet shows that in the world there are many people who go through life unnoticed and unappreciated. Thank you, friends, for watching my video.